Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for setting the tone for this sunrise service. Let's acknowledge our gratitude to the Vanderveens for... Thank you so much. I want to share some scripture with you this morning. It's not traditionally part of the Easter scripture that we always read and retell the story. It comes to us a little bit earlier in John chapter 12, starting in verse 27. It says this, "Now is my soul troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But for this purpose I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." This is Jesus speaking. And witnesses witnessing. And verse 29 says, "The crowd that stood there and heard it said that it had thundered. Others said, 'An angel has spoken to him.' And Jesus answered, 'This voice has come for your sake, not mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now will the ruler of this world be cast out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself.' He said this to show by what kind of death he was going to die. So the crowd answered him, 'We have heard from the law that the Christ remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man?' Jesus said to them, 'The light is among you for a little while longer. Walk while you have the light, lest darkness overtake you. The one who walks in darkness does not know where he is going. While you have the light, believe in the light that you may become sons of light.'" Jesus must be lifted up. Jesus must die on the cross. But he doesn't stay dead. He doesn't stay dead, does he? We gather here this morning to remember the empty tomb. But it's important that we don't read this just like a story, as some kind of fable, that we find ourselves in the story. You're in the story. You have a story. So what I'd like to do is get you in the story. We're going to do a responsive reading. It's not something we do all the time. But let me remind you how this works. I'm going to read the red slides, and you're going to respond with the yellow slides. This is your part. This is your part. So be loud. Say it out loud as we go. And if you're not in unison, it's okay. So let's get in the story here. Jesus rides into Jerusalem upon a donkey. The crowd cheers, laying palm branches at his feet. Jesus prepares his disciples for what's to come. The God of the universe kneels and washes their feet, instructing them to do likewise. Oh, you guys sound so good. Jesus is arrested and unfairly tried. An offer is given. Rome can release Jesus, the Messiah of the notorious prisoner Barabbas. The crowd responds. Pilate asks, "What should be done with Jesus, who is called the Messiah?" "Crucify him." Our response. Give us Barabbas. Jesus is mocked. beaten, a crown of thorns viciously pressed into his brow, forced to carry the tool of his own execution, he stumbles. Nails are driven through his feet and his hands. The cross is raised before the glaring crowd, his charges visible. Soldiers cast lots for his clothes. He thirsts and is given vinegar. He cries out in desperation, my God, why have you forsaken me? He gives up his spirit. Days later, the women head to a borrowed tomb where his body has been placed, but the large stone blocking the tomb has been rolled away, his body gone, and it's in this place. In its place are nicely folded burial clothes. An angel says, he's alive. He is alive. Christ the Lord is risen today. He has conquered death. He is risen. Amen. Find yourself in the story today. Remind yourselves and brothers and sisters what today is all about. We celebrate a tomb that is empty, a tomb that could not hold our Savior. And because of that, we have a way back to the Father. Today is a great day. Today is a great day. Today is the pinnacle of our faith. It all hinges on the empty tomb, the sign that we may find salvation. Just a moment here, I'm going to give thanks, and we're going to invite you to have breakfast with us. A fellowship with one another. There's eggs and pancakes and sausage and fruit, and if you go away hungry, it's your own fault, I promise you that. We're so grateful for the opportunity just to come together, but it is a little bit different. I'm going to ask that before you go through the food line that you put hand sanitizer on, please, everybody. If you put hand sanitizer on the way out to the food area, put it on again as you go through the food line. Also, please don't take any dishes back up to the food line. Throw the plates away and get new dishes, okay? We're trying to be prudent and smart here, yet still fellowship with one another. So I'm asking that we all do our part, put on a little hand sanitizer before we go through there. And let's celebrate. Let's celebrate an empty tomb. Today is a happy day. Today is a great day for that. Let's give thanks for it. Father, thank you so much for the opportunity just to gather here and be reminded of the empty tomb that our Savior lives. And because he lives, we also may live. Bless us this day and every day. Bless the food that we're about to eat. May it nourish our bodies and help us grow strong as individuals and closer as a family. We ask that you bless the hands that have prepared it for us as well. Bless us this day. It's in Jesus' name we ask, and everybody said, amen. Let's eat.